Hello, my wonderful friends out there. This is Ian here, and today's lesson, you know, since I love being a teacher, so I love giving lessons on the board. You know, I bought this the other day, and I thought maybe, you know, it just makes things clear to you or and to me when I'm giving you, so that I don't have to always repeat myself. However, today we're going to speak about the importance of being, you know, beingness, isness, you know. We are taught in the Western world that you have to do something. You have to take massive action. You have to do something in order to have something, in order to be something, so that you can be happy. You know, we think you can be successful, but you must first do. You must first work hard. Now, there is nothing against working hard. However, this being, you know, we have this paradigm, be, do, and have, because you are a human being. However, a human being and not a human doing. That means the secret lies in what are you going to be today? Now, that is very simple. You can just choose. You can be love, be compassion, be courage, be confident, or if you want, you can be rich. The thing is this, how can you be these things if you don't feel it? If you don't feel them, how can you be them? The truth is, you are these things. You see, you have a part of Prime Creator inside of you. And since Prime Creator is all of these things, is love, is compassion, is courage, is confident, is rich, because Prime Creator created everything. So since you have Prime Creator living within you, you are these things. All you have to do is to admit it. And if you admit it, that you are these things, you are love, you are compassion, you are courage, you are confident, you are healthy. Because you have to just admit and say, I am these things, you know, because that's what you are. You be these things. I be healthy. I be successful. How about that? And by simply admitting this, proclaiming it to yourself, right, and proclaiming to the world, you will notice there is a big difference that's going to start happening to you. Your frequencies are going to raise higher when you admit that. You declare that to yourself, and then you declare that openly, that you are these things. You know, we are always speaking about the lack of peace in this world, the lack of love in this world, the lack of friendship in this world, the lack or the abundance of fear in this world. Now, my suggestion to you today is to stop doing that. Proclaim and declare that you are the light. Proclaim and declare that you are love. Proclaim and declare that you are compassion. Proclaim and declare that you are health. Proclaim and declare that you are peace. Proclaim and declare that you are one with everybody and everything. Simply proclaim that and declare that. Now, my suggestion to you for today is to go out and simply be these things for one day. Just for one day. Just try this. Go out and be confident. Go out and be love. You know, you are love, so you love everybody that you meet. Go out and be compassion. It doesn't matter who you are or who you meet. Just have compassion for just be compassionate to everybody that you meet. Now, if you follow the rule be, do, and have, that's what happens. You be it, and then you do it automatically, because when you are it, when you are love, you do things that are loving, right? When you are compassion, you do things that are compassionate. When you are courageous, you do things that are courageous. When you are confident, you do things that show a confident person. When you are rich, you do things, you speak about richness and wealth and abundance because you are rich. Now, rich is not measured in the amount of material goods you have. Rich is in your mind, is in your soul, is in your being. You are rich because you are part of the Creator. The Creator lives within you, so therefore you are rich. Therefore, like I said in my previous step, you can manifest anything you desire, should you desire it, because you are all these things. And if you're all these things, you can manifest power. You are a powerful being. You are not in slavery. You are a powerful person. You are a powerful being. And nobody is above you. Hey, did you listen to that? Nobody, no entity is above you. Now, you are also not above any entity. We are all one. Remember, we are all one. And if you go out today and live this oneness, this beingness, this isness, and my suggestion to you, don't worry about the future, because you will create the future by your beingness today. You are just you are. I am an individuation of God. I am. That's what I am. That's what you are. That's what we all are. We are divine human beings. And we are being. And every day when you are being something, when you have an argument with someone, ask yourself, who am I being? When you have an argument with your significant other, ask yourself, who am I being? Who am I being? Not who's right and who's wrong. When you are in strife with someone else, and which can end up in some sort of war, ask, who am I being? Because who you are, who you decide, and you decide that, who you decide to be, that is going to influence your life. And it will really change your life. And you will get yourself on a higher plane of consciousness, a higher plane of beingness, a higher plane. You are going to be one with God. God is within you. Now, God is not up there. God is within you. So all the attributes of God are within you too. And all you have to do is today is to proclaim it and declare it loudly. In the face of what's happening in the world today, declare this absolutely loudly. No matter what you are seeing in your life or what you are seeing around you, declare this truth loudly, clearly, frankly, openly. And when you do that, you are changing your life. And you are changing the environment around you, and you are changing the world, and you are also changing the universe. Namaste. So have a good day today, and talk to you again. Thank you very much. Bye for now.